Alrighty guys, we are just 3 days away from Star Wars Celebration, which is going to be the time and release of the official debut of the teaser trailer and the title reveal by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, one thing about this movie that a lot of people are really curious about and are very interested in is, of course, the first set of footage of this film in the form of a teaser trailer that will allow fans to get an overall idea of the tone of the movie and exactly what J.J. Abrams is going to do in order to end the Skywalker saga. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and one of which has all to do with various shot descriptions of what will appear in the teaser trailer come this Friday on April 12th of 2019. Now, what's really intriguing about all of this is that shot descriptions consisting of Kylo Ren sitting in his chambers in front of the Darth Vader helmet, holding it in one hand. It's said that Kylo is examining Vader's helmet without his mask on, giving a different view for fans of Kylo's emotions when seeing his grandfather's mask. The background is described to have a lot of white lights, as if Kylo is on board of a ship like the Tantive IV. The next goes over Rey wielding Anakin Skywalker's lightsaber on a large battlefield, raising her saber up like a sword, where it's described that she is sending a signal for an army of resistance fighters and Kanata's pirates to move forward. It's described to be a shot that mimics something directly from Game of Thrones or Lord of the Rings. Another goes over Kerry Russell's character, codenamed and or named Zori, on a speeder with her helmet on, dodging blaster fire from a large First Order building in the distance. It's said that she appears to have a wound on her arm while riding on the speeder. The next goes over glimpses of the Knights of Ren marching with Kylo down a set of big stairs into a dark basement of sorts with bright lights behind them. While Kylo's saber is ignited, it's described that this is the dark spire that will appear in the second act of the film. The last goes over Kylo walking through a swampy world with his Knights of Ren, where it's actually said that they are in knee-high water. It's said that it has a real Vietnam feel to it all in that particular sequence. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this, obviously, because this seems like it really is going to be quite amazing when it all comes down to the final film of the Skywalker saga. Now, in case you guys did not know, J.J. Abrams borrowed a lot of elements from World War II and Vietnam in order to really make this movie feel very unique between both the First Order, the Resistance, and even this new threat that is going to have a big role in the second and third act of the film. So first things first, I really want to go over this swamp world. Now, we heard about this, I would say, during the summer of 2018, right around when they began filming, at the very beginning of August. And this swamp world, by the way, is said to be a mixture of Dagobah and, of course, Endor. And you could only imagine what's really going to happen here. Now, we do know that Kylo Ren and his Knights of Ren actually traveled to a swamp world to seek out this creature called the Oracle. Now, the Oracle is going to provide a lot of answers, and it somewhat reminds me of the Bendu of some sort. It's a gigantic spider-like creature. And this swamp world that we actually hear about, I believe that this is indeed the same exact location that Kylo Ren and the Knights of Ren are traveling to. Also, keep note how Kylo and his knights are actually said to be walking in knee-high water. So that right there is a direct nod, you know, to the Vietnam War. And I think that what J.J. Abrams really is trying to do is he's trying to really make this film have a lot of callbacks, right, to not only the prequels and the originals, but also really kind of using our own wars that we have gone through, you know, in our reality. You know, World War I, II, Vietnam, etc., right? The list goes on. We do know that J.J. Abrams is using a lot of that in order to make this film feel very, you know, unique and original. Now, the other thing that I do want to go over is, of course, one of which that has all to do with the character of Kylo looking at Darth Vader's melted helmet while Kylo Ren's helmet is off. So keep in mind that J.J. Abrams is giving us a different version of that scene that we got in The Force Awakens, where Kylo is talking to Vader's helmet, where now in this scenario, in Episode 9, Kylo is actually going to be looking at Darth Vader's melted helmet without Kylo Ren's helmet on. We're going to be able to see Kylo's emotions as he is looking at the helmet, something that we have never seen on the big screen as of yet in the sequel trilogy. You know, in The Force Awakens, we could only guess how Kylo was reacting and how his facial expressions really were when he was talking to Darth Vader's melted helmet. Now we're going to be getting something just like that while Kylo Ren's helmet is off. So that's one thing to look forward to for sure, and I think it's going to be a little bit more emotional that way, to be honest with you. The last thing that I do want to go over quickly is, of course, how there is one of which involving both Kerry Russell and Rey. So the one of Kerry Russell has described that she has a wound on her arm, the character named Zori. So this could very well indicate and connect to what we went over just a couple of days ago about Zori going up against the Knights of Ren and Kylo Ren for a small scene. And of course the Rey scene in which she is directing a whole entire army of Resistance troopers slash fighters. And of course Kanata's pirates to head toward the First Order headquarters, as if it's something out of Game of Thrones and Lord of the Rings. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night.